اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد. All those who join us and said salam alaykum salam, and those who didn't write salam and said salam alaykum salam. بارك الله فيكم. So we are in Surah Al-Infitar. الله. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد. ما الذي أولياء الله؟ بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إذا الكواكب انتثرت. الله. We mentioned the meaning of إذا السماء انفطرت. When the heavens. We mentioned that this surah is one of the three surahs Prophet mentioned. إذا الشمس كورت. إذا السماء انفطرت. And إذا السماء انشقت, that those paint a picture as if you are seeing it when you understand the meanings of these surah and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is conveying in them. And that's Prophet's hadith. So when the heavens, the skies are split asunder, are munfatir is split, you know, open. وَإِذَا الْكَوَاكِبُ انْتَثَرَتْ, and when the stars are dispersed, fallen, and وَإِذَا الْبِحَارُ فُجِّرَتْ, when, اللهم صلي على سيدنا محمد, the oceans explode, and here, اللهم صلي على سيدنا محمد, سيدنا الحسن said that Allah سبحانه وتعالى will cause some parts of the oceans to burst forth over other parts of it, and that water in some portions of the ocean will disappear, and that fresh water will mix with its salt water. وَإِذَا الْقُبُورُ بُعْثِرَتْ, and when the graves are shaken or moved, بُعْثِرَتْ, and that's at the time when the soul, when the people are resurrected, people come out of the graves. عَلِمَتْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ وَأَخَرَتْ, at that time, and this is the same theme in this surah that we have went over, that every soul on judgment day will be confronted with reality and the truth, that this life is not for nothing, as some atheists believe. You reach a you die and that's it, you disappear. No, there is a continuity and a continuation, and whatever you've cultivated in this life, whatever good actions, bad actions, positive actions, negative actions, they remain with you. They are part of your soul. They are part of the part that continues with you eternally. So everyone will know exactly what they've done. Alimat nafsun, what they've done in the past. And now, in وَأَخَّرَتْ, and in the future, and what will occur. Everyone knows, and this is also, when confronted with the reality, everyone will know what they've done, and everyone will know what is coming as well. مَا قَدَّمَتْ وَمَا أَخَّرَتْ, عَلِمَتْ نَفْسٌ مَا قَدَّمَتْ وَمَا أَخَّرَتْ. يَا أَيُّهَا الْإِنسَانُ مَا غَرَّكَ بِرَبِّكَ الْكَرِيمِ. O human being, what deceived you? What caused you to be deceived, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad, that you would not be considerate that you have a generous Lord who created you for a purpose? مَا غَرَّكَ, يَا أَيُّهَا الْإِنسَانُ مَا غَرَّكَ بِرَبِّكَ الْكَرِيمِ. What made you careless? And this is not a question, this is a threat. Meaning, what caused you to have such ill manners with your Lord? It is not a question, it is a statement Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made, and a warning. Allah and the Mufassir here, Sayyidina Ibn Kathir, quotes this hadith, يقول الله تعالى يوم القيامة, يا ابن آدم, on judgment day Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, O son of Adam, O son of Adam, what deceived you? What made you so complacent, so careless? What made you take your Lord for granted? يا ابن آدم ماذا أجبت المرسلين؟ ما غرك بربك الكريم؟ What have caused you to be so careless and so negligent with your Lord? The one, your Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the next, الذي خلقك فسواك فعدلك, the one who created you. You come into this world and as if you brought yourself into this world, as if you made yourself, created yourself and brought yourself into this existence. Or even more useless philosophical ideas, that somehow this world came from nothing and it created us. So nothing created something, and that something created another something. Very wise ideas. الذي خلقك, he created you, فسواك, fashioned you perfectly, فعدلك, in great proportions, in perfection. What has deceived you? And in another hadith, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قال الله عز وجل, يا ابن آدم أن تعجزني وقد خلقتك من مثل هذه. How Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, how can you escape me? How can you escape from me? Yeah. How can you avoid coming in front of me, يا ابن آدم, and I have created you from a drop of liquid, made you from a sperm. When I fashioned you and perfected your creation, and you don't clothe on you, and you walked on the earth, and then I caused you to die, and you were buried in that earth. Huh? وَلِلْأَرْضِ مِنْكَ وَإِيدٍ. And this earth has, you have in this earth you have a burial place. But when you reach that, فَجَمَعْتَ وَمَنَعْتَ, and you collected wealth, and you, manat means you withheld that wealth until you left dunya, and your wealth, you did not spend it in Allah's way. And فَجَمَعْتَ وَمَنَعْتَ حَتَّى إِذَا بَلَغَتِ التَّرَاقِي, when your soul was leaving you, you said, أَتَصَدَّقُ وَأَنَّ أَوَانُ الصَّدَقَ. At that time, you would say, oh my Lord, give me time, give me respite so I can spend my wealth in your way. And at that time, Allah says, the time for giving sadaqah passed. Now, when you're dying, you want to give sadaqah? And this shows the importance of sadaqah. That at the time of death, when the veils are lifted, the deceased, the one who is leaving dunya, will see the value of charity, will know the importance of charity in one's eternal the eternal life that one is about to go in. And because of that, he doesn't ask, oh my Lord, let me stay so I can pray, so I can fast. No, أتصدق وأن أوان الصدقة. And then Allah, the Holy Quran is saying, وفي أي سورة ما شاء ركبك. In whatever form, الذي خلقك, created you, fashioned you perfectly, and in whatever form, surah, he put you together. Some say that this is the ta'wil in Sayyidina Ibn Kathir, it's meaning in whatever resemblance he wanted you, he made you. He made you look like your mother, he made you look like your father, like your uncle. Whatever way he wanted to fashion, he fashioned you. عن سيدنا ابن كثير اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد mentions the hadith to elaborate this point that a man came to Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and he says my wife has given birth. He wasn't he wasn't black, and he went to Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. He wasn't a person his complexion wasn't too dark, but his boy that his wife gave birth to was actually dark. So he went to Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he says, complaining that my wife gave birth to a black child. And Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, do you own any camels? He said, yes. He said, what color camels do you own? He said, I own a reddish color. He said, فَهَلْ فِيهَا مِنْ أَوْرَقْ. So is there some camels amongst them where they have gray patches? He said, yes. And Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, فَأَنَّ أَتَاهَا ذَلِكْ. Where did the gray patches come? When the two male camel and she camel are both reddish. Where did it come from? And the man said, basically, that maybe it is genetic. وَهَذَا عَسَىٰ أَنْ يَكُونَ نَزَعَهُ عِرْقٌ, means something caused through the genes. And Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, and this is like that. But I've heard some ulama give tafsir of this ayah, فِي أَيِّ سُورَةٍ مَا شَاءَ رَكَّبَكَ, in whichever form he put you together, to mean because we were in alam al-dhar, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, before we were in, when we were atoms, when we were potentials, that was a world we were in, and in that world we were in a form, and then we came to this world, alam al-arwah, the world of souls, and then in that world we also had a form, and then we came to this world, and in this world we have a form, and then we will go to the barzakh, in the grave, and in that world we will have a different form, and then on judgment day we will have a form, and then in the heavens we will have a form. So it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is putting us together in different forms according to the worlds we are in, and it is a beautiful ta'wil. كَلَّا بَلْ تُكَذِّبُونَ بِالدِّينِ, verily you deny the day of judgment, you deny akhirah. وَإِنَّ عَلَيْكُمْ لَحَافِظِينَ كِرَامًا كَاتِبِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ مَا تَفْعَلُونَ, and you with you there is حافظين, there are angels watching you. Sayyidina Raqib and Sayyidina Atid, two angels are watching, are with the believers at all time. As kiraman, honored, katibin, means they don't leave anything you do except they write. They know all that you do, and they write. Noble guardian angels over you. Writing down everything you do means we think we are by ourselves, and that's why most of the evil things happen at night time, and they happen in closed quarters away from people tend to do. Why? Because they think that no one is seeing them. And this reminds me of a story from Sayyidina Abdul Qadir Jilani, who had a favorite murid, and other murids were jealous from. And this murid wasn't a scholar, wasn't anything special amongst the murids, but the sheikh liked him so much. So everybody was jealous of him, and the sheikh perceived this, and he wanted to teach them why this person is special. So he asked them one day to all come to him and bring a chicken, and he said, I want you to slaughter the chicken. go find a place that there's no one sees you and slaughter the chicken, bring it to me and give it to the kitchen, and at the end of the day we will have a feast inshallah. So all the murids, everyone went, they got the chicken, they went, they half an hour, 2 hours, they brought the chicken, slaughtered, cleaned, ready to cook. Except this this murid was unable to, no one can find him. And then Maghrib time is coming, he's missing. So the Shaykh said to go look for him, see what happened to him. They went, they found him still carrying the living chicken and walking around. And the murid scolded him, says, the Shaykh is waiting for you. He told us in this morning to go do this task, and you still haven't even slaughtered the chicken that you have, and he's waiting for you. He took him to the Shaykh. And the Shaykh said, oh, my son, what happened? Why didn't you slaughter the chicken? He said, my Shaykh, everywhere I went, I couldn't find a place where I was, no one can see me. You said to slaughter the chicken in a place where no one can see you. I could not find a place where I didn't feel you are looking at me. I didn't feel Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is looking at me. Huh? And the story is, even if nothing, we as Muslims believe we have two angels, Raqib wa Atid. Kiraman katibin ya'lamuna ma taf'alun. وَإِنَّ عَلَيْكُمْ لَحَافِظِينَ كِرَامًا كَاتِبِينَ. Guardian angels with you all the time, writing everything they do. Now بِاللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ. If we really believe the hadith of Prophet ﷺ, if we really believe that we have two beings with us writing all the time everything we do, and if we're not heedless and negligent, can we perform things that are unacceptable? If we really believe that we will be taken to task for the what we are doing. No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is seeing us. And these angels are seeing us and writing. يَعْلَمُونَ مَا تَفْعَلُونَ. Everything you do is documented. And then the surah goes into, again, comparing the two types of people in this world. إِنَّ الْأَبْرَارَ لَفِي نَعِيمٍ. The righteous ones will be in delights, in bliss, in happiness. وَإِنَّ الْفُجَّارَ لَفِي جَحِيمٍ. And the rebellious, disbelieving ones are going to be in hells. يَصْلَوْنَهَا يَوْمَ الدِّينِ. They will experience its fires on Judgment Day. وَمَا هُمْ عَنْهَا بِغَائِبِينَ. And not for 1 minute they will have rest from that fire. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ وَمَا يَوْمُ الدِّينِ. And what do you know about the Day of Judgment? Not a question, it's again a warning and a statement. Means you have no idea about that day and what that day will contain. ثُمَّ مَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا يَوْمُ الدِّينِ. Again Allah repeating, what do you know about that judgment day? يَوْمَ لَا تَمْلِكُ نَفْسٌ لِنَفْسٍ شَيْئًا وَالْأَمْرُ يَوْمَئِذٍ لِلَّهِ. You say, on that day, when no soul will, اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد, when no person shall have power for another, no one can help anyone, no one will be able to benefit anyone on that day or help him except by Allah's permission. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may allow some people to intercede. For example, Hafidh al-Quran can intercede. The martyr can intercede. Those whom Allah for his family, the awliya, Allah gives him permission to intercede. Believer can intercede. If Allah gives him permission, Prophet ﷺ will have the grand intercession. But here, as a rule, that no one without Allah's permission can benefit you on that day. Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us, make us from those who will be happy in al-abrara, make us from abrar in na'im, and don't make us from the fujjar of jahim. And this is Surah Al-Infitar. وَالْأَمْرُ يَوْمَئِذٍ لِلَّهِ. Everything is in Allah's hand. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وَيْلٌ لِلْمُطَفِّفِينَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا اكْتَالُوا عَلَى النَّاسِ يَسْتَوْفُونَ وَإِذَا كَالُوهُمْ أَوْ وَزَنُوهُمْ يُخْسِرُونَ ألا يظن أولئك أنهم مبعوثون ليوم عظيم يوم يقوم الناس لرب العالمين. ويل وو unto ويل ويل is a warning. It is said it's also a valley in hell. ويل ويل للمطففين. Who are the مطففين? Tafifin is that they're not fair. Those people who are not fair. And how much this world who deal with people unfairly, unjustly. How many of those people are in this world today? Mutaffifin, they're stingy. They want everything for themselves. That's why Allah is saying وَيْلٌ لِلْمُطَفِّفِينَ. Why? الَّذِينَ إِذَا اكْتَالُوا عَلَى النَّاسِ. Those when they have to receive, when they deal with you about something, they want you to give them, يعني the scale has to be leaning towards them. الَّذِينَ إِذَا اكْتَالُوا عَلَى النَّاسِ يَسْتَوْفُونَ means when you're dealing with them, Their side of the scale has to, but when you are asking, when you have a right from them, they put less for you in the scale. الذين إذا اكتالوا يستوفون على الناس يستوفون وإذا كالوهم أو وزنوهم يخسرون. Those when they have to give by measure or weight, give less than is due, and when they are asking, when they want more. So unjust people, unfair people. And now in today's world, if you look, the whole economical system is built on unfairness. You have one person now has 100, 200, 300 billion. And you have countries, their total GDP, their total budget for the entire year, maybe 5 billion, 3 billion, 10 billion. So one person has owns more than entire countries. You have countries with power taking advantage of countries with no power. This is on country scale, but also on an individual scale. We live at a time where if you can use gimmickry and cheat people to get ahead, it is considered something good. You know, if you can find ways to scheme to become rich, yeah, it's good. Greed is good in today's world. So we are living a life now where the majority of the world, this mutaffifin can be applied on. And a great example also before, and we'll end with this, is what is happening right now in Palestine and Gaza. What happened in Ukraine, for this is a perfect example. So in Ukraine, Russia invaded Ukraine, and the whole civilized world decided it's unacceptable for a country to invade another country. They brought down the rules, the laws, embargo, everything. Alhamdulillah, yeah? We want rules. We don't want anybody to invade countries. And then you have the poor Palestinians under occupation for 75 years, abused, used, everything taken from them, and being killed. And 6 months into it, not even one decision. This is tatfif. One scale like this, one scale like that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lift the affliction of the people of Palestine. We'll end with this, inshallah. ومن الله التوفيق بحرمة الحبيب بحرمة الفاتحة. صلي على محمد. Thank you all for joining us. Anyone who said salam, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Inshallah, we will continue tomorrow. Don't forget that you have one accepted dua daily at the time of iftar. So use it, don't lose it. And assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.